interesting neck.
She's a woman.
Morning.
Women, they shout a lot.
It's Monday, February 25th. We're just catching up with the weekend there. Yeah, so all you probably would have heard is something to do with women and shouting a lot.
God, they're always shouting.
The context of that. Today's going to be a decent enough day weather-wise. Well, it's going to be dry, which is good. Mainly cloudy. You might get the odd patchy mist of drizzle, but generally dry and cloudy for today. And we'll see temperatures of about 13, 14 or 15 degrees as well. Wasn't a bad day yesterday.
Yesterday was lovely, wasn't it?
Got loads of clothes dry just out the line I did.
Well, you will be very proud of me. I hung clothes out.
Did
but
you?
But woke at about 3 a.m. this morning and remembered they were still out.
Ah, yeah, you see, that's the problem. And then what happens is they get the dew and they get all damp again.
They're still out. What'll I do now? Will I just leave them out now today?
Leave them out and then set a reminder to collect them.
Collect them.
Go and collect them.
I must collect the clothes.
Bring them in around 3 or 4 o'clock and see how they are. Check them when you go home, right?
Okay, yeah, yeah,
and if
they're
still a bit damp, leave them till about 5.
Okay, cool. I love that you're good at that stuff. Speaking of collecting clothes, I'd love to just be one of those people who just brings it off somewhere and gets it done.
Oh, yeah. Una started watching, what's your one's name, who does all the cleaning and the organising?
No.
What's
Marie
her name?
Kondo.
Yeah, that's it, yeah.
Can I ask you something about her? Firstly, I don't get it. It's mental, right?
Me neither, but yeah.
And secondly, why... is her name Mary? I thought that was a pure Irish thing.
Yeah, well, she does. She speaks very little English. I didn't realise this.
Do you know what I mean? Like, I thought that was pure Irish. Now there's this, like, Mary. Japanese woman and her name is Mary Kondo.
Mary Kondo.
And, like, everyone's calling her Mary. But is that actually her name? Do you know?
I don't know. I think it was Marie. I thought it was Marie Kondo.
Mary.
I will say this, and I know people watching this video and people who listen to us on the radio have began to watch her as well and they're into her or whatever.
Yeah.
I only saw 15 minutes of an episode yesterday before I left the house.
Yeah, yeah.
And Una was sitting there watching it and it was coming towards the end. So what happens is she comes along, she tells you what you should clean and then comes back a week later to check, right?
Okay, yeah. God.
That's basically
like
the entire premise of the show. But she arrives back anyway and she goes into this house and she's like, oh my God, you've done such an amazing job. And she looks around in the place.
Thanks, Mary.
All they did in the episode I saw of the 10 or 15 minutes was all this shite that was just kind of thrown everywhere.
Yeah.
They packed into storage boxes and then put the storage boxes where the shite used to be.
It's like my utility room is just
like
full of shite. Yeah, it's just like you kind of have to be careful going in the door in case stuff falls out.
Yeah.
But like, what would Marie Kondo say about my utility room?
I don't know, but like it was tidier, I'll give her that.
Yeah.
But it was still stacks of boxes and stacks of shite. Anyway.
I'm doing up my sitting room at the moment, okay? And my mum and dad were in looking and they were kind of like, a nice little press over there and a nice table. And I'm like, no, there's nothing. They were like, what do you mean? There's no furniture that can, all that is are shite gatherers.
Yeah, because they've got presses and drawers that'll fill up.
I've got two drawers in, right, I've got this thing with my Skybox and my DVD player and all that gets used once a year. And there's two drawers in there and there's toys in those drawers that my daughter played with when she was 1.5. She's nearly 8.
Get in, Mary. Mary,
so,
sorted out for you.
Mary, I need help with the shite gatherers.
Yeah.
So there's none. I'm doing up my sitting room and there's going to be none. None. Nowhere to put stuff. So it's going to be like Japanese minimalist heaven.
Yeah, I give you 6 months.
Scandinavian.
I give you 6 months and you'll have bought some sort of chest of drawers or some sort of table with a cabinet or something.
I hate it. Anyway. Let's check out today's
papers. Let's look at the papers,
Irish Daily Mail front page today. Childish Leo is goading Fianna Fáil, says Micheál Martin. Well, the confidence and supply deal continues. However, the leader of Fianna Fáil now accusing the Taoiseach of goading Fianna Fáil for its support of the government and said that his remarks have been immature and childish. That's on the front page of today's Daily Mail. Meghan Markle pictured. She sparkles in diamonds at something. I don't know. She was appearing at something. And she's in the front page of the Irish Daily Mail. They've really fallen out of love with her. Articles over the weekend now about how she's spending too much money and people don't like that she had that fancy baby shower. And even though supposedly it was a private thing, so it was all paid for by herself. And blah, 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 blah.
I did read the story about the baby shower, actually. And my first thoughts was, so?
Yeah.
Who? So, like,
she's wealthy in her own right.
Leave her do whatever she wants. But anyway, the Times Ireland edition this morning has a picture of the Irish rugby team, the Connemara try yesterday on the front page there. A very lackluster
Irish rugby team. Oh, it was crap, wasn't it?
Credit to Italy, they played very well, but Ireland were just so. They're also on the front page this morning, May delays crucial vote until 17 days before Brexit. So the 29th of March is when they're supposed to have the Brexit deal. She's now after pushing back this vote on her new deal until the 12th of March, so I don't know what's going to happen here. And on the front page as well, first for football, Man City win the Carabao Cup as Chelsea descend into anarchy. We'll come back to that in a minute because it's one of the top trends as well this morning, but chaos yesterday at the Carabao Cup final.
Oh, I didn't see that. I just read about it last night. It sounds
madness.
Absolutely bonkers. I presume that's one of
totally
our trends
bonkers.
This morning as well.
It is, yeah.
Offenders to train to become barristers, baristas. Not barristers, in Cork. Some of Ireland's highest risk young offenders are now to receive professional training as baristas or coffee experts. That's under a new initiative, and that's in the Irish Examiner today. Some of them could become barristers too, that have a lot of the right training.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
They've the work experience done, the work placement sorted.
Yeah.
And the naked truth, nudism is a unique escape from labels, writes Kelly Maria Corducci in the Irish Examiner today.
Yeah, I thought it was an interesting story.
Taking in the warmth of the sun and your bare butt while trying not to stare at anyone's penile jewellery, Willie, is easier said than done, she writes. So that's all about nudism. And have you ever done it, Andy?
Never done it, but that's what fancy sunglasses are for, lads.
Nice.
So the pair of sunglasses
are
for. The Independent this morning says plan to delay Brexit again for another 2 years. I'm not playing chicken, says Taoiseach, is the headline there. And an awful story from the weekend. A 16-year-old boy was driving a car at 5 o'clock in the morning and he was killed after it crashed into a wall. Four other teens were injured in the crash as well on a foggy country road in Carlow, in Barras. Mount Leinster and Barras in Carlow. So an awful story from the weekend. That makes the Irish Independent there as well this morning. Some of the top trends then. The Oscars were on last night.
Yeah.
Olivia Colman won Best Actress for The Favourite for playing Queen Anne. Rami Malek won Best Actor for Bohemian Rhapsody playing Freddie Mercury. And the Best Picture went to Green Book, which up until yesterday I'd never heard of.
Never
checked it out at all.
What was the hot favourite? Roma.
The foreign language movie.
That had been a really hot favourite to win. So, a little bit of a
surprise.
It
won Best
perhaps.
Director and it won Best Foreign Language Film. Okay. It obviously didn't win on Dinesh.
Yeah, the Green Book was the other one everybody was talking about, right, the last couple of weeks. So.
Yeah, Lady Gaga did win for Shallow. Herself and Bradley Cooper won for Best Original Song.
Come here, there's all these rumours now that she's broken up with her fiancé and that, like, gas.
Oh, sure, of course.
Complete speculation. Yeah. Like, they couldn't possibly just be, like, able to perform together and have chemistry on stage without being at it. Like.
And isn't he going out with a...
she's unreal.
Sexy model lady.
Irina Shayk.
Shayk.
Is she Cristiano Ronaldo's ex?
Okay. Yeah, they were.
She's
they were,
gorgeous. Unreal.
They were kicking boots for a while.
This isn't on our top trends, but it is something that everybody's been talking about over the weekend.
Yeah, Momo.
Do you know who that is?
Yeah. It's like something out of Beetlejuice.
So ugly.
Yeah.
So Momo is this new online game that's apparently been responsible for at least one child to... I can barely get my head around it, to be honest with you.
It's
to take their own life, to commit suicide. Horrible game. You need to talk to your kids about it. You need to, not just that, you need to talk to your kids about what they're up to online. You need to keep tabs on it. Everyone's gone completely mental now and there's frantic chats now about Momo. Like, you actually have to download it, right?
Yeah.
You know, it's not like going to jump out of the child's tablet.
Yeah, what's happening is that it's popping up as a free ad and then they're pressing on it and then it downloads and then...
So Google Momo, find out what it is and talk to your kids about it. And I did it over the weekend. I ended up just terrifying my child. Kind of went a little bit wrong. And my friend who's a teacher was there and I was like, did I handle that well? And she was like, definitely, hon, you did. And I could see her kind of going... Whoa.
Yeah, it's a terrifying
parenting thought, classes.
Yeah, absolutely. It's awful.
Yeah, and I think, Google it and we probably won't explain it properly, but talk to your kids about that.
Kepa is trending this morning. The Chelsea goalkeeper who refused to come off yesterday. So it's not a new thing that when you're heading towards the end of extra time and penalties, that managers will decide, right, you're a really good goalkeeper, but he's a better penalty saver, so I'm going to put him on and take you off.
And he was a little bit injured too, right?
I'm not sure about that. He refused to come off. It wasted 3 minutes. The referee had to get involved. The referee eventually cancelled the substitution and Maurizio Sarri lost the plot, and rightly so. And they still lost the game, by the way. So that's one of the top trends this morning. And for some reason, again, Virgin Media TV must have some sort of deal done that they showed the snapper again last night.
Well, they've moved away from Steven Seagal into Cullen Meany territory.
You and I are doing this breakfast show together 4.5 years and we're doing this video nearly 2 years, and I'm telling you, the snapper has been trending a lot more than just once every couple of months, because it's madness how many times
it is
great. Oh, it's a great film, but they're always showing it.
I know, I think you showed
it
a lot. Yeah. So we hope you had a great weekend. We'd love to know what you got up to. What did you do? A good win for Kerry. Well, a 1-point win, but they won again, so that's the most important thing. Against Galway, there'll be more on that in Terrace Talk this evening from 6 here on Radio Kerry. What else happened over the weekend? Tralee Warriors won.
The Kerry Hurlers won.
Oh, I was at Rhyme to the Mime, kind of lip sync, for Ballyduff over the weekend in Ballybunion. We had a great night, so hi to everybody there. They were raising money for their ball wall, which I kept calling a wall ball, which is something else.
Anyway, right, we better wrap up because we're going to go live on the radio in about 30 seconds. So enjoy the rest of your day and happy Monday. Good luck.
Bye.